So maybe if you could just kind of start by providing a bit of an overview of TMR technology and maybe how it differs from other sensor technologies.
Sure. So, I mean, ferromagnetic is using TMR technology in position sensors. And when you talk about position sensing, magnetic position sensing, there's basically, two major, effects that you can use. The one, and that is the best known, is probably Hall effect. It was developed many years ago, and Hall sensors have come to many limits in terms of, size of the effect, usability, and thus performance of the final position sensor. The other group of effects would be the magnetoresistive effects, starting with the AMR, anisotropic magnetoresistance, which was found first, and then in the 80s, and that drove the development of hard disk, was the giant magnetoresistance, GMR. And the latest development since the 90s, or was found in the 90s, the effect is a TMR tunnel magnetoresistance. And basically, you got two ferromagnetic layers that are coupled but separated by a very thin non-magnetic, non-conductive layer. And that's what's called tunnel magnetoresistance. So basically, the electrons will tunnel through that boundary. And depending on a magnetic field, since an electron has a spin, so its own magnetic properties, there will be different scattering of those electrons depending on the external magnetic field, leading to a change in resistance of that sensing element. So and the big advantage of TMR over all the other effects is just the size of the effect. So to
Okay.
put it in perspective, compared to the AMR, the effect is approximately a factor of 100 larger. It's a factor of 10 larger, at least, in the GMR. And larger effect just means, better signal to noise ratio, more sensitivity, and thus, when it comes to position sensing, better accuracy, higher resolution, to put it in a nutshell.
Okay. And so what I since you were kind of touching, like, are you able to go into a little bit more of what some of it's benefits of using the TMR technology versus other sensor technologies might be, or maybe like some of the applications that might be better suited for as well.
Yes, I mean, TMR is taking over magnetic sensing overall, because it's just the biggest of the effects. But coming from our perspective, making position sensors, as I said, it's the size of the effect, the better signal to noise ratio, less influence of temperature, less influence, of mechanical tensions in the setup, in the PCBs you solder those sensors on, just leads to a higher quality position sensor. In our case, it's all about, resolution and accuracy of the sensor. To put it into perspective, with TMR, you can now finally get close to the resolutions of optical sensors. I mean, optical sensors historically have been the ones with by far the highest resolution when it comes to rotary encoders. Capacitive also leads to high resolutions, just because you can scale the size differently, but optical has dominated that field. And with TMR in particular, you can get close to those high resolutions, which just opens up a much broader market for magnetically based position sensors, into applications that formerly were just reserved for optical sensors, with all their advantages but also disadvantages.
So, are there maybe specific use cases or maybe like components or systems that you see these best being integrated with or into?
Yeah, I mean, in general, I think the more let's start from the beginning. I think in general, the rotary encoder world is using more and more magnetic sensing instead of optical sensing. I think the main driving factors are size and cost. Cold magnetic technology is typically not developed just for position sensing. It's more for mainstream applications. I mentioned earlier hard drives, not anymore. Now everything is solid state, but it used to be the hard drives for the GMR. And TMR Hall, strongly driven also by automotive. Lots of magnetic sensing in automotive. So we are talking about a different, economy of scale when it comes to sensors. And that leads to less expensive, base sensing elements that can be used in rotary encoders for machine sensing. The other thing is it's just more rugged and robust. When you think that more and more position sensors are used on off-highway equipment, think excavator, bulldozer, whatever. Sure, there's ways to do this with an optical sensor, but when it comes to the outdoors, when it comes to shock and vibration, when it comes to condensation, you don't really want to work with an optical system. So these are the driving factors to go magnetic. When it comes to TMR in particular, and for Fraba, I mean, we have early on decided to go with this kind of magnetic sensing from the market side, but also from the R&D side, because we strongly believe in doing our own data processing in the sensor. So we really use raw TMR signals from a high quality TMR sensor, can be provided by many players, so these kind of sensors. But then we do the whole signal conditioning data processing ourselves, which gives us a whole lot of flexibility. So for us, the secret sauce are the algorithms to get to those high resolutions, to get to very short cycle times, as you might or will need them on motor feedback applications and these kind of things.
Maybe how do you foresee the use of this technology evolving in the coming years? Are there new application uses or further advancements to the technology you maybe see or?
I think TMR is a fairly new technology, so there will certainly be advantages in the sensor technology itself, which primarily will lead to sensors where you have, even less temperature sensitivity, even tweak in the effect to a much bigger size, getting even bigger signal, better signal to noise ratios, et cetera, et cetera. On the other hand, you're going to talk about the cost side. You will see TMR sensors, even further going down in cost, making the whole system cost lower. And that for encoders means, again, the trend we mentioned earlier, smaller encoders, less expensive encoders with better and higher performance.
Well, I think those are all the questions I had for now. I don't
Okay.
know if there's anything else you would like to add or think our audience should know about TMR sensor technology or how Fraba is utilizing it.
Well, as I said, I mean, we could talk just about the base technology of TMR forever. So, but that's probably not the part of that interview here, going into those technical details. No, but I think, as I said, I mean, TMR enables sensor manufacturers, position sensor manufacturers in our case, to come up with higher performance systems with smaller form factor and also more cost efficient, which just broadens up a whole different market.
Right. Are you seeing, because we've kind of heard it before, are you seeing more people wanting smaller, more compact sensor designs?
That's for sure. That's for sure. I mean, for the customer, it's all about the functionality and to use to solve a measurement problem, to solve a position sensing problem in the case of our sensors. And here, I mean, the driving factors are typically form factor, reliability, which includes the ruggedness of magnetic technology in general, and costs. And so these sensors certainly enable us to do so. I mean, if you look at it from a general perspective, I mean, as I said, I think I said it earlier, magnetic sensing is taking over the rotary encoder industry for sure. I mean, there still is a huge market for optical encoders, no doubt about that historically. But if you would go through any given, global player on rotary encoders, you will see that I don't think there's anybody anymore that doesn't offer magnetic units. And I think the new developments are primarily magnetic. I mean, we at Fraba started looking into magnetics in around 2000s, actually before that, like 1999. 2000, we started looking into using magnetics, being confident that this will take over. And well, hindsight, we were right. We also decided using a magnetic multi-turn system, which uses energy harvesting. So it's also a very nice combination. You got the one magnet spinning, and then you can run two systems of it. You can run the single turn, but you can also run the multi-turn counter in the encoder with the same magnet. And that is where we think it's a very, consistent and well integrated approach to rotary encoders, absolutely, or to multi-turn encoders in that case.